So, hello again. I just came to realize I have never really made an introduction of myself. About my past, my family, and all those things. So this is what I'm going to do today. Yeah, I am an eclectic witch. That's been it for... since forever. And apparently into lies too. Like I said in an earlier video, I now live in something called a sundry, alone with my cat, the witchy, and my spider. Yeah, I got a big spider. He's pretty. I first started out with all this witchy stuff when I was about 14, 15, before I even knew what it was. I started automatically to collect things in a box I had, like stones, herbs, and candles, and shells, and all kinds of little things that I saw meaning in. So, and then I did something really bad. I got mad at my dad one day, and I cast a curse on him. And it worked, and I got so scared. I threw everything out. The box, everything in it, everything just went out. And actually today I'm still a bit anxious, nervous about making spells, because I know that they work, and I know that if it's your bad intention, it will come back to yourself. Yeah. Did that. And I think somehow still I'm paying for it in some ways. So I kinda left all that aside and just I'm just normal. Like everyone else, but on the outside, but inside I was in a bit of a chaos because I just lost a big part of my identity. So then I was 19 and I went to this thing called in high school. It is a school when you're done school, before you start education and stuff like that. So I don't really know what to call it in English, but it was for young people in the age between 16 and 19, doing creativity, singing, sewing, drawing, painting, theater, stuff like that. And I met this girl who was Wiccan, and I was like, oh, so that's what it is. Read some books I bought from her, and like, yeah, this is me, this is who I've been always. So I started calling myself a witch. I never was a Wiccan, just because it felt wrong for me, which is more natural for me to say. And so it was just that I said I called myself a witch. This is who I am, this is my beliefs. And people would like look weird at me, like, yeah, alright. It's just a thing, you'll get over it. And my parents still do it, and now I'm 27. They still say it's just a thing, and I'll get over it. And my mom has started to accept it, and she's like, oh, my little witchy, and calling me all these things. Buying stuff for me, finding things for me. She found these lace things. She found these free meat horns in plastic from a place in Copenhagen called Valhav. And she's like, oh, you brew meat and you like meat, so you have to have these horns. Like, just like plastic to see through. But it's such a nice thing anyway. And she bought me like this little witch statue of a the regular witch you see in cartoons and stuff with the big nose and the warts and the pointy head and just like a cartoony witch, and she was so sweet. And she's on my altar for my crone. And my dad still tries to discuss it with me. And putting it up like being a witch versus being a Christian and all that. It's very fun sometimes, and sometimes I get just a little bit irritated and mad at him for just like, I just want him to accept it. My brothers, I got two younger brothers, 24 and 21. And my entire family was like, well, we are Christian, but we don't practice. Very typical Danish Christian family, I would say. And they'll bring me things too, like witchy bottles, like little bottles for herbs and for oils and stuff. And even my grandma, my dad's mom, would come with things for me. She'll like a big bottle, like a big flask that I can have things in. And oh, I just found this cauldron. Can you use it? It's very nice. So they are starting to accept it now, luckily. Like I said, yeah, I'm eclectic. I have never been in a coven or a circle. And now I'm actually starting to miss that. To miss being with others, to celebrate with others. Just to feel a part of a community that believes in the same things that I do and celebrates the Sabbats and Esbats and all that in a way that I can relate to. I do have my spirituality group, as I call it, on Mondays, but it's not the same. We are talking about crystals, about herbs, learning every week. We have a new crystal, a new herb, so we are learning about that. But we don't celebrate the Sabbaths. And I really want to do that. I really want to feel that connection with others. I have found it so hard to find anyone or any just other people in my area that would like the same. And because I don't have a car, it's actually pretty damn hard to get around. So even though if I found some coven or circle further down in the country, it would be hard for me to go there often. So, but I still want to do it. I think it could be interesting. I could learn so much from it. Like I said, I've been alone with this for so many years. I went to a witchy meeting when was that? That was like 5 years ago, and then it kind of faded out because of personal problems. And then I started again 2 years ago when I decided like to really come clean to everything and everyone and all that. And I met someone for that I could relate to, and we had the herbs and stones, and we were yay good friends until she kinda betrayed me. So that's my experience with the coven or circle. Like that one person that didn't turn out being that a great person anyway. But I really, really miss it. I really would love to have someone to celebrate with, someone to just to be with and have the same beliefs. I don't have to sit there all the time and kind of fight for my beliefs and what I do. It hurts. It really does. I'm beginning to feel very lonely, and that's not a very nice feeling. But I'm hopeful someday I will find a coven, find a circle that I can join in. And he had to be with. That would be so nice. Other than all that, like I said, I have my cat, Gizmo, somewhere. I have some videos of him on my YouTube channel. He is 1 year old now. He's about, and I call him my little rescue kitty because I kind of rescued him from where he lived when he was a tiny kitty. He was half weight of the weight he should have been when I got him, so he would have been dead in a week. And now he has grown to this big, beautiful cat. He's a pest, but I love him. And then I have my tarantula that I've had that for like 3 years, I think. And just think they are a fascinating animal, and you can learn a lot from them by watching it and just meditating over it. What you see, and then yeah, like I said, I have 2 brothers and a mom and dad. I have 2 grandmothers. Actually, 3. I guess I got 2 dads. I have 3 female cousins and 5 male cousins. 3 and 5 uncles, I think. Small family, a lot of contact, really only at certain time of year, like traditions. So I'm finding it pretty hard that most of our traditions have like faded out after we grew up. I'm really running out of words now, but I hope you just got a little view into who I am as a person and why I do the things I do, why I am the way I am. So, bless be and goodbye.